Hi everyone, welcome back to another episode of Friday First Cut series. I am Nithi Manchanda, a certified financial planner and head of training and development at Fintu. Let's say you made a capital gain of rupees 5 lakhs on selling of mutual funds, and in the same financial year you made a loss of 1 lakh rupees as well, maybe on selling another capital asset like gold or real estate. In this case, should you be paying your taxes on 5 lakh rupees or should you pay your tax on 4 lakhs, which is the net gain for that particular financial year? Well, the answer is not a straight yes or a no. In some cases, you will have to pay tax on 5 lakh rupees, and in some cases, you will be allowed to set off your losses against gains and will be allowed to pay tax only on 4 lakhs. And this will depend upon whether your loss or gain is short term or long term. Now if we see, as per Income Tax Act, short term capital losses can be set off against short term capital gain as well as long term capital gain. On the other hand, if you talk about long term capital losses, this can be set off only against long term capital gain and not short term capital gain. This set off can be done irrespective of which capital asset you have got your long term, short term gain or loss. It's nowhere mentioned that loss from one particular capital asset has to be set off against the gain from the same asset itself. In a recent case, an individual who is also a director of a company, he sold some unlisted shares, and long term capital gain from such sale of unlisted shares was set off against long-term capital loss from the sale of real estate. The tax department had questioned the set-off as it's from different asset classes, but the ruling said that any individual or company can actually set off long-term capital gain from the shares with the long-term capital loss from real estate. The ruling further said that not every tax planning can be treated as a tax avoidance. Income Tax Appellate Tribunal held that it is legal to use tax planning and set off long-term capital losses against long-term capital gains irrespective of the nature of capital asset. Also, please note that in case you do not have any gains in the current financial year, you can carry forward your losses to the next financial year, and in the next year if you make any gains, you can set it off against it. To carry forward your losses to the next year, it is mandatory to file your income tax return before the due date, and for the current assessment year, the due date has been extended till 31st December 2021. So make sure that you file your returns early and before 31st December. In fact, do not wait till the very last date and file your income tax returns now. You might have a further question, as in for how many years you can carry forward your losses. Well, in case of capital losses, you can carry forward it for 8 assessment years. I hope set off of capital losses is now clear, and for any further query regarding set off, feel free to get in touch with our tax experts, and for more such videos, do subscribe to our channel.